My name is Josh. I'll be your student nurse today. Before we get started, I'd like to just confirm your first and last name and date of birth, please.
Caroline Allison, 21888.
Okay. Great. Okay. Perfect. Okay. How are you doing today, Caroline?
I'm okay. I really don't like these things on my legs.
Okay. Well, tell me about more about why you don't like the SCUD devices on your legs.
Well, these stupid squeezing devices on my legs are driving me crazy. They're itchy and noisy, and I want them off.
Okay.
Why do I have to wear them? They're pretty ridiculous.
Well, during postoperative recovery, when you are immobile, it is important to have your legs under some compression to prevent some blood clotting from forming. The leg compression devices help prevent the clots.
Why would a clot form? I've never had one before.
Okay, well, while you are laying down healing, the circulation to your legs is reduced. When blood sits, it tends to clot up. We don't want that blood to clot up, as it can stick to the insides of your veins and collect. Sometimes the clot can get big enough to where it can even block off a vein.
Okay, well, why is a clot a big deal? It sounds like something that could be easily fixed. I'd rather not have these stupid things on if I don't have to.
Understandably. Well, unfortunately, that opens up a whole other can of worms. If a clot were to loosen, it could travel up through your heart and into your lungs, and this could prevent your lungs from getting oxygen to the blood. We initially want to prevent the blood clot from forming, but if one does form, we want to be very careful in how we proceed.
So will I get a blood clot if these come off? What am I supposed to do when I go home? I'm not going to wear these all the time, am I?
Well, in the next few days, you will be able to walk around and move around more. This will decrease your chances of forming a clot. However, we will make sure that you watch out for certain signs and symptoms of the clot forming.
Okay, so what should I look out for?
Okay, there are several things to look out for. Redness, warmth in the leg, usually to one side. Specific pain in the leg, usually that same side. The pain could feel like a Charlie horse, like a severe cramp. However, if you do start feeling these symptoms, do not panic, just give us a call. We may have you undergo some imaging to further evaluate your symptoms. The reason why we want you to look out for this is that a clot can move to the lungs and cause some other symptoms. Some of these may include shortness of breath, chest pain, maybe worse with like a deep inhalation, unexplained cough, may cough up blood, and unexplained increased heart rate. We will give you a handout today that has all this information, so you have a list of symptoms to watch out for.
Well, that sounds terrifying. Thanks, Nurse Josh.
Yeah.
Is this really something I should worry about?
Well, once you start getting up and moving around, your risk for forming a clot will significantly decrease. Other risk factors that would include having a previous blood clot, family history of clots, having a clotting disorder, obesity, smoking, and being over the age of 60.
Definitely no.
Yep.
Okay, well, none of those apply to me,
sure.
So that's awesome.
Mm-hmm.
But what if I can't move around enough? What if it's too painful? I mean, I just had abdominal surgery.
Well, there's another option. We can also give you some compression socks to use at home, which will help prevent the clots from forming.
Okay. All right, so I should give you guys a call if I'm having any redness, warmth, or pain in one of my legs?
Absolutely, yes. There are some other factors that can put you at a higher risk. Certain birth controls, pregnancy, or other hormone therapies. If any of these pertain to you, just make sure that you discuss it with your provider to see if this is something you need to alter while your healing is going on.
Okay, I think I'm gonna be having some hormone therapy post-op, so
I'll
definitely make sure to talk to my doctor about that.
Good. Okay, so I think we're kind of finishing up here. Do you have any questions regarding anything I've said today before I leave?
Nope, I'm good.
Okay, so I've got a couple questions for you. What kind of things are you going to watch out for?
Redness, warmth, and pain in one leg.
Great, and can you reiterate to me why these devices are important?
These stupid squeezing devices are important because they keep my blood moving to prevent a clot.
Perfect. Okay. And can you tell me what else you're going to do when you get back home?
I'm going to try to resume activity as soon as possible.
Wonderful. And finally, what are some of the things you can talk to your primary care physician about?
Medications or treatments I'll be on, just in case it's a risk factor.
Great. Okay. Awesome. I think you got everything. Here is your call button right there. Looks like you got it.
Okay.
And I have this pamphlet for you. So
fun.
If you have any questions, just let one of us know.
Cool.
Thank you, Caroline.
Yeah.
Did I say that right?
Caroline.
Okay. Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Nurse Josh.
Yep. See you around.
Okay. Bye.
Okay.